Good morning, class 6. Myself, Ranjit Kumar. I welcome you all in the e-learning program of Modern English School, Kuntinagar, Nawada. This is the first and the introductory video of the chapter Movement of the Body. Movement means not only moving from one place to another. Movement within the body is also, if you remove your hand from here to here, you lift something, that also is called movement, is speaking. That also is due to some movement that is going inside my body. So, in this chapter, we have to talk about the movement of the body. So, different type of movement. So, one thing we know from class 5, skeletal system. What is the skeletal system? The framework of the bone that gives shape to the body is called skeletal system. So, skeletal system, or it is called skeleton. So, this whole skeleton together forms the skeletal system. So, imagine if I want to lift my hand, so first I have to decide that I have to lift my hand. So information, it is controlled by the brain. So it means nervous system is there and muscles help in the movement of the hand. So muscular system is there and one skeletal system is there, that is the bone. Means I can say nervous system, muscular system and skeletal system together help in the movement. If I am standing here, something is coming towards me, and when it came closer, I saw that this is a stone. So when I saw that this is a stone, immediately my brain decided, oh, it is a stone, I cannot stop it. So immediately your brain will send signal to your legs. So your leg will lift you and it will move aside, and stone will pass away. So you will be saved. Same scenario I am saying, this time someone has thrown Costco ball from that side. Like the stone was coming, Costco ball is coming. Your brain saw that, okay, Costco ball is, something is coming. So by seeing, okay, I have seen this is a Costco ball, it is a soft type of ball. Everything brain concluded in fraction of second. And immediately it sends signal to the hand, catch the ball. So when ball was coming, brain sent the signal to hand to catch the ball. But when stone was coming of same size, then brain sends signal to the legs to move away. So we can say nervous system decides what kind of movement is going to take place in our body. First thing, and that kind of movement is brought about with the help of muscular system. And muscular system along with the skeletal system help in the movement. So we can say nervous system, muscular system and skeletal system together help in the movement. So in this chapter we are not going to see everything in detail about nervous system, muscular system and the skeletal system, but roughly I will say muscular system includes muscles. Different muscles are there in our body. So many type of muscles are there in our body. So these muscles all together form muscular system. Next is nervous system. The nerves, the spinal cord and the back brain together means the nerves, the spinal cord and the brain together form the nervous system. Nervous system control all the other function of the body. Next is skeletal system. You know, in from class 5, you know the definition of skeletal system means frame. What is skeleton? The framework of the bone that gives shape and support to the body is called skeleton. In the skeleton, we have to see limbs, we have to see the rib cage, we have to see brain, we have to see backbone, everything we have to see. And you know, different kind of joints are there, ball and socket joint here, that pivot joint here, gliding joint here, and the hinge joint here. So you all know from class 5 that joints means place where two or more bone meet is called joint. So different kinds of joint is there, movable joints and immovable joints. Immovable joints are found only in the skull, and movable joints are found in different, means it is different type of movable joints are there: ball and socket joint, hinge joint, pivot joint, gliding joints. These all things we have to see in this chapter. We have to see skull, we have to see spines, backbone. Backbone is made up of 33 small bone called vertebrae, and that's why the backbone is called vertebral column. So the small hollow bones, 33 small hollow bones make the backbone. So this backbone is called vertebral column or vertebrae. Rib cage, you know, the cage like structure that is made up of 24 curved bones or 12 pair of curved bones, and these curved bones are joined in the front with the breast bone or sternum, and at back it is connected to the backbone. If you count the last two pair of the ribs, this curved bones which is connected only to backbone, not to the sternum, is called floating ribs. This all information is there with you from class 5. I am not saying a single new word. अभी तक हम एक भी नया बात नहीं बोले हैं. जो भी बोले हैं सब आपको पहले से मालूम है. Okay? Next, in shoulder back, this ball and socket joint is there. So it help in maximum and movement. The hip joint, pelvic girdle. This is the new topic that you will see in this. Next is leg, foot, all these joints, ball and socket joints, hinge joint, gliding joint, pivot joints. See, one more thing you have to see in this topic, from last information from class 5 only is there, but with some more changes, means some more information. You know, you remember, if you remember from class 5, especially 5B, they must remember that the muscles work in pair, means you muscles can only pull, it cannot push. So minimum two muscles are required for any kind of movement. For example, if I want to lift my hand, these muscles has to contract. And if I want my hand back to the normal position, this muscle should contract. So these two muscles together bring movement in my hand. So one thing we know, that muscles can only pull, it cannot push. So muscles, minimum two muscles are required. And these two muscles that work in pair, for example, this is the biceps, this is the triceps. So these together is called antagonistic muscle. antagonistic muscle. So these all things, this is the new term that we have to see in this class. And after that we have to see how snakes show movement, how snake move, and how fish swim. All these things we have to see. After that we will see how birds fly. In that also some information you have. Birds can fly because it have boat shaped structure, and it has hollow bones and muscle. Instead of limbs they have wings. Some information you have, I will go in detail. How earthworm move, how insect move, and how snail move. All these movement we have to see in this chapter. So basically you have to see a skeletal system. You are not going to see about the nervous or muscular system. Somewhere you will see some term about the antagonistic pair of muscles. Few terms you will have to see. Otherwise mainly we are focusing on a skeletal system, different type of bones. More thing we have to see, this skull, this which we call brain, It is called cranium. New term is there. Substance, the topic is same, but new term is there, because as you are going in senior classes, na, some scientific term get added. Okay, so you all will read the chapter and I will try to send one animation if possible. Okay, so read the chapter, and if anyone have any problem, you can ask. First you read the chapter, find the hard word, and if you have any problem in hard word, make sure to ask. You have to ask the question. You can ask on my personal number. You have to ask until I answer. See, don't ask like you are asking anything. Sir, what is skeleton? What is muscles? Try to find yourself. अपने से डिक्शनरी देखिए, गूगल कीजिए, सर्च कीजिए, जो नहीं समझ में आए. इफ यू कांट फाइंड एनी वर्ड, यू कांट अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म, देन यू आस्क मी. अदरवाइज यू कैन डू बाय योर ओन. ओके, चलिए. ओके, थैंक यू.